See, soft tissue sarcoma is one of the commonest thing in a big medical institutions, but they are rarer in smaller institutions because the entire thing is only less than 5% of all the tumors that are presenting in the for treatment. We have to have a good clinical evaluation, which only tells you the various aspects of the behavior of the tumor, and you need to understand that the clinical evaluation is important than the type of pathology, because grading is important when compared to staging. Staging depends upon the behavior of the tumor, but more often it is the grade that matters. See, initially they were calling it as a fleshy tumor by Sachs and Claudius Gallens, and it was a era of amputations, and subsequently came the limb sparing surgeries, and it's predominantly in the soft tissue. So we need to discuss only about the soft tissue. The bony component we will not discuss. So you have various advances that has taken place. First is the diagnosis.
Evaluation is important.
Pardon? You have the MRI, which gives a biopsy-like diagnosis, and you have histopathology and immunohistochemistry, genetics, genetic studies help you to differentiate the various types of sarcomas. We have novel delivery system, which are now coming up in vogue with the monoclonal antibodies. They're all very useful for the treatment of sarcomas. For students who are mainly appearing for the exam, we'll have it like this. The sarcoma is a mnemonic for size. See, the size of the sarcoma matters in the entire diagnosis, staging, treatment, even for chemotherapy. If you have a 5 cm and less, it is a good one. And 5 cm and more, it behaves faster and prognosis is bad. Anatomical marks, landmarks must be assessed. The plane of the swelling, like head raising test, muscle control test, all that are done to know the anatomical landmarks. Regional nodes, see, generally it is, we are all taught as a student, medical students, that carcinoma spread by lymphatics, sarcoma spread by bloodstream. But there are situations for less to 5 to 10% regional nodes are involved, and it can produce compression, and compression means it can produce not infiltration but physical compression in the blood vessels, gut and all this in a patient, produce compressive effects. Then regional skin soft tissue effects. A previous biopsy is the worst villain in the treatment of sarcoma. I will explain to you on that. Wrongly placed biopsy scar is one that is very treacherous in the management of sarcoma, big sarcoma. Then metastasis is very simple. All gastrointestinal metastasis goes to the liver, and all sarcomatous this thing goes to the lung, rest of the body. So you have metastasis from the gastrointestinal tract, particularly GIST, goes to the liver. The thigh metastasis goes to the lung. And whether there is a need for an amputation is also assessed in the clinical examination. And the one of the common things which you are aware is the neurofibromatosis 1 and 2. They have more propensity to develop some varieties of neuroendocrine tumors and nerve sheath tumors are all very rarely they spread to the lymph. And you would like to see the biopsy placed scar. The surgeon has put a transverse biopsy. That means he has to sacrifice it subsequently when you go to excise. This transverse thing needs more skin to be utilized and excised. So you'll have very difficulty in getting it across. See, the role of genetic changes in this etiology of sarcoma. You have etiologies due to environmental factors, radiation. I'll just mention about it in subsequent slides. They're all more common in these syndromes, which are all well documented in literature. Nevoid basal cell syndrome, Gorlin syndrome, Gardner syndrome, Leif Remini syndrome, tuberous sclerosis, von Recklinghausen's disease, Werner disease. All these are supposed to be very propensity to develop greater frequency of sarcoma as a soft tissue. Radiation in a child is usually in tuberculosis those days, but now lymphomas have been given, and lymphedema, the CA breast produces lymphedema. Long-standing lymphedema of the upper limb produces tuberous lymphangiosarcoma. Gardner syndrome of the abdomen with polyposis can have skin nodules which can coerce on to desmoid tumors. STS is the most common type of a radiation-associated tumor. The development of sarcoma is in 10 years. You have somebody having a radiation, particularly the osteogenic sarcoma in a childhood, 10 years old. And they'll have subsequently 20th year they'll develop malignancy. The shortest latency is for liposarcoma. The longest latency is for leiomyosarcoma. And etiology is mainly radiation and genetic causes. See, this is very simple. How a malignancy doubles or grows in or appears in cancerous production. Epithelial tumors and squamous cell carcinomas and adenocarcinomas, you have normal, then dysplasia, then severe dysplasia, then in situ, and then progressive goes on to carcinomas. And in fact, borders classification for a best squamous cell carcinoma is also in the same line. And you have sarcomas, they start de novo. They don't progress on by fibroma becoming fibrosarcoma, never occurs. Lipoma going on to liposarcoma, never occurs. See, the controversy is this almost settled in the origin of soft tissue sarcomas from undifferentiated mesenchymal stem cell. This is the question in the exam. Where do you get the soft tissue sarcoma arising from? It arises from undifferentiated mesenchymal stem cell. And virtually anywhere in the body. So that's why you get nerve sheath tumors, which are normally neuroepidermal sheaths, which develop mesenchymal and neural, which is ectodermal combination. Nodal metastasis is supposed to be absent in sarcomas, but these are all the sarcomas, bractomyoma sarcoma, epithelioid myxoid sarcoma, clear cell carcinoma and vascular sarcoma spread to lymph nodes in 5% situation. And people have done even a radical nodal dissection. Then, having seen all this in the patient, four clinical features should be viewed with suspicion. Increasing in size of more than 5 centimeters. The growth of increase must be very rapid or irregular. Deep to the deep fascia, and pain is rare and trivial trauma. You have people developing malignant sarcoma. Average duration is 2 to 3 months to seek medical attention. My own statistics in the last 35 years is about 180 cases have been done, and that has been incorporated into this presentation. And what is the distribution of sarcomas? And mainly liposarcomas. So you have majority of them are extremities. 40 to 50% of sarcoma attending a hospital OP is always liposarcomas or malignant fibrous histiocytomas. There is one thing I tell you about malignant fibrous histiocytoma later. And it visceral component is about in 20%, 1/5 of our in abdomen. You have proximal and distant limb. Proximal limb has liposarcomas, distal limb has got epithelioid sarcomas, then upper hand, upper limb produces clear cell, and lower limb produces synovial sarcoma. If you have something around the ankle, the diagnosis is synovial sarcoma probably. And if it is upper, it is clear cell sarcoma. This is how it is described, but it's not a strict protocol. Head and neck malignancies, high incidence in pediatric age group, and their rhabdomyosarcomas, Ewing sarcomas, and round cell sarcomas are common. So now you can see, if a person with sarcoma arising in the lower limb, the ankle, you can say it is, we are dealing with synovial cell sarcomas. So you can give a clue, but the modification of treatment is very minimal. And you have a variety of sarcomatous lesions. And there are about 500 subtypes are available. And there is no question of analysis of a potato and a tomato. And each one behaves in its own. The biology of each tumor is a critical role in determining the ultimate oncological outcome. So it is individual cell, how it behaves, decides the fate of the patient. You have various genetic factors which have been got into and then evaluated for the origin of sarcomas, which we normally call it as undifferentiated mesenchymal tumor. Anything which is rapid, and also patients' native drugs, application of native drugs, these two produces ulceration and distal complications. Like suppose you see somebody with a shoulder deltoid sarcoma, which is liposarcoma, it is very difficult to operate because it is to have a four quarter amputation, which is a major surgery for the patient. Then I wish all the postgraduates who are appearing for the exam go through these Enzinger's and Wyss soft tissue tumors textbook, which is given all aspects of soft tissue sarcomas. And I wish everybody go through it. Actin, immunohistochemistry for certain things can give a clue. Actin demonstration, CD34, cytokeratin, desmin, factor 8, S100, vimentin, and sarcomas. Many, many sarcomas are coming under this immunohistochemistry, which can always be done. So the course of management is FNAC, true cut, then frozen section, IHC, genomics. Genomics is almost merged with the chemotherapy which you are attending to. And also immunohistochemistry and frozen section are very important in the diagnosis. Value of CT, MRI in soft tissue sarcoma. See, the MRI Doppler can visualize the vascular involvement. And you can also see the Doppler thing measuring the flow. The local extent of the tumor, MRI is considered as the gold standard. HRCT is the test of choice for chest and abdomen. PTCT is the avidity is equivocal. So what are the investigations you'll do? One, for sarcoma imaging, you use an MRI, which is a differentiated, well-differentiated, atypical liposarcoma. It can even give a biopsy report. It can tell you, it can differentiate between benign and malignant for sure. So there is no need for a biopsy. You can straight away go for surgery and then wait. And another question that is asked is, when do you remove the biopsy in a thigh tumor, or you do a excision biopsy? When you have a tumor of 3 centimeters to 5 centimeters, you can consider, if it is possible, a primary excision biopsy is done. Otherwise, there is no excision biopsy in sarcomas. Beyond 3 centimeter diameter, it is not done. Primary tumors are MRIT, weighted image defines the anatomy. MRA gives you a clue of the anatomy. And major vessels in the limb can be assessed by spiral CT, and you have an abdomen with CT and biliary tree with MRCP. The most common site of metastasis in the extremity is lung. Even in lung, it is very simple. The pathologist gives it as a great tumor, low grade tumor. You have every this thing to do only CXT because you are exposing the patient to a lot of radiation. Stage 1, low grade tumor, simple X-ray chest is good enough for particular medical colleagues. High grade tumors, CT chest is always done. Retroperitoneal and visceral sarcomas, GIST place spreads to the liver, so liver imaging is important. Then, fibrous tissue tumors, varying grades are aggressive behavior. You have a clinical examination, I told you, benign tumors, it can be multiple. Fibromatosis can be multiple sites, or it can be hard. Malignant tumors are aggressive, particularly malignant fibrous leukocytoma. Now, what you should know is pleomorphic undifferentiated sarcoma is earlier as called as malignant fibrous leukocytoma. If you go into the history, it is myogenic tumors, fibrogenic tumors, lipogenic tumors. That's all. Now, each one is again compared with vengeance. You have pleomorphic undifferentiated sarcoma, and that is the same thing as malignant fibrous leukocytoma. Then liposarcoma is divided into 4-5 types. You have a very well differentiated atypical liposarcoma, good prognosis. All the rest, like a myxoid variety, round cell variety, dedifferentiated variety, and pleomorphic variety, are supposed to be very virulent. Synovial sarcoma is para-articular in the lower limb. And MPNST, I told you, malignant neural, peripheral neural sheath tumors. These are all the things which are included in pathology. And there should always be a sarcoma management committee, a tumor board, which tells you what is going on and decides on the further course of the treatment. The best indicator for tumor biological aggressiveness and metastasis potential is grade. Grading is not useful in Ewing's, AS, alveolar soft part tumors, and epithelial sarcomas. So you have a teamwork, you'll have no problem. Grade is assessed and as per the AJCC and FNLCC, the French and the American Civil. So this is the 8th edition. 7th edition has recently been found and minimal alteration has been found in the 7th to 8th, but not much. They normally go from stage 3 to N1. Stage 3, N3, N1 and N0. They change it. Probably for a previous section it would have been metastasis, then it become not a metastasis, then it says the lymph node is the N3. So there are changes which take place as they go with more and more evidences. So what do you normally tell the patient? Simple. It has been accepted that you need not go and explain to him all thing about alveolar soft part sarcoma, which you may not be also be knowing much as a surgeon. Poor and good prognosis, divide them into two. Anything less than 5 centimeters, anything more than 5 centimeters, proximal location, we have it in the deep, below the deep fascia, and a high grade G3, it is given as low grade. So they are having a very good prognosis. Otherwise, distal and superficial fascia, good prognosis. TNMG staging is the American staging which they have included for grading, including grading. N1 is stage 3. That is the earlier this thing has been changed. Excludes GIST, desmoid, Kaposi sarcomas. Excludes. Includes angiosarcomas and dermatofibrous sarcoma. Grading, 2 grades, 3 grades, 4 grades. 4 systemically, 3 different varieties are there. Now again, we'll not get into too much of pathology. We'll see the fine needle aspiration biopsy is done within the area where you're going to operate. Even a through cut biopsy is not put from behind. Somebody will say, you put it from behind, it'll be cosmetically better. And cosmetically better in the thigh is no use. You have incision and drainage site. The B is the drainage site, which is kept close to the incision. The incision should always be vertical. It should not be horizontal. The biopsy incision is important. This is what is normally asked in the exam for postgraduate MS. In biopsy track, you have a reactive zone. Some containment zone, you have a reactive zone. So what really happens is, when you remove the thing, reactive zone outer thing must be removed. There is no question of leaving it. And it infiltrates outside. It is more of a pressure necrosis and not a infiltration, aggressive attachment. Sarcomas respect anatomical borders. But if you see a person with carcinoma pancreas, it will be infiltrating entire to the portal vein, supraconcentric vein and all that without impunity. So, what is the mainstay in treatment is sarcoma, is amputation. The main goal is maximal oncological control with least functional impairment. But if the major neurovascular bundle is involved, pelvic floor involvement is there, extra compartmental extension is there, but, and then palliative pain, we have no other choice except operating an amputation. Denting types of surgery has been nicely elaborated in all the surgical textbooks. Recurrences. Early recurrences in dependent on grade. Late recurrences depend on the size. This is very useful. You have high-grade tumors, tumor more than 5 cm, violation of tumor capsule, positive margin. You are aware that if you violated the capsule, you are reducing the metastasis, reducing the longevity. And there is one thing called as Kawaguchi's concept of barrier effect, where you have compartmental excision and all this is no longer done. You reactive zone go beyond, you give 1 cm clearance, and if it is very close to the fascia, you can not open the fascia, you can keep it to bind the tumor, and what we call it as don't see the tumor when you're operating. Then lesions like limb sarcoma, particularly proximal limb, you have a gluteal maximus sarcoma, a differentiated liposarcoma. You find you cannot achieve R0 resection. It has to be R1, so the patient needs subsequent chemo or radiotherapy. It may be of any size, but it is a liposarcoma. So you have a clinical imaging biopsy, it tells you a low-grade tumor and a high-grade tumor. Low-grade tumors are operated surgical excision, the margin is free, follow-up. The margin is positive, do an adjuvant RT for a low-grade tumor. For a high-grade tumors with surgery, adjuvant radiotherapy. Or rhabdomyosarcomas, Ewing's, neoadjuvant tumors and surgery. Wide local excision. See, this is one of the patients operated who had a big liposarcoma in the anterior compartment. Flexor compartment. So you should have a good knowledge of the arterial flow and that will help you to go through the barriers. You have free margin achievable, extensive violation free, resection is possible, but the prognosis is usually extremities are high, the trunk is less, retropatellar tumor poor. I think I already told you about reconstruction, chest wall, proximal muscle group excision, retropatellar sarcomas, and all difficult. Similarly, neurofibular sarcomas are malignant nerve sheath tumors in the supraclavicular region, one of the big difficulty to the surgeon because it infiltrates under the brachial plexus and you have variable upper limb dysfunction. See, you have multiple things. As if a post box you have put drops, everything, you can take it out. Vascularity is minimal and you have liposarcomas, recurrent. I have operated one person for the last 5 occasions because he had liposarcoma. The patient comes every 4 or 5 years for a sarcoma release. See the amount of liposarcoma in the abdomen. Then kit-assay and imatinib is what you need to know about GIST tumors. And stomach is the main place where you get a GIST tumor. But the idea of operating on a GIST tumor is no spillage, no breaking of the tumor in the abdominal during dissection. Recurrent tumors is the property of the gene. Property is a narrow place. So you have this MRI shows there is a growth which infiltrates onto the bone as well, and also it infiltrates the artery. And this is therapeutic embolization, this is just an infusion. In salvage chemotherapy, some of the liposarcomas behave very poorly, but some are very long prognosis achieved. So preoperative radiotherapy, local control can be given. Postoperative radiotherapy, local control is given for margin spillage. Postoperative radiotherapy is advisable. Brachytherapy, surrounding tissue span. Surgical resection is done after radiotherapy, before radiotherapy, and the surgery is done after neoadjuvant chemotherapy. There are various groups which are given, which are useful to have a neoadjuvant protocol. Palliative chemotherapy and isolated limb perfusions are useful. So this is what I was telling you. Neoadjuvant chemotherapy, 3 groups of patients that you consider. Group 1, high risk of metastasis, rhabdomyosarcomas and living sarcomas. High grade tumors larger than 10 centimeters. Moderate size tumors with chemosensitive group 3 tumors. 3 groups are given. Round cell liposarcomas, pleomorphic liposarcomas, synovial sarcomas and leiomyosarcomas are the common things that are responding to neoadjuvant chemotherapy. Neoadjuvant chemotherapy is a very important thing in sarcoma. A new drug called trabectin in soft tissue target-oriented sarcomas. It is also called MTOIR and TRAIL. And I think it is advanced very much. We need to be discussed with the chemotherapy medical oncology. This is another of my team in Madras Medical College. Thank you.
Any questions from the audience, please raise your hands and please come up and ask your questions. Anyone from the audience?
Yes.
Any questions?
Yes, please. Nothing.
Yeah, Nishant.
Yes, please.
Hello.
Yeah, please tell me.
Sir, actually, you have told that for Ewing's and rhabdomyosarcoma, we can give neoadjuvant chemotherapy followed by surgery. But actually, if it is not Ewing's or rhabdomyosarcoma, if it is a liposarcoma, leiomyosarcoma, or any other tumors, the size is very huge. Like if it is 15 centimeters in the gluteal region or somewhere in the thigh or somewhere, yeah. Is there any role of neoadjuvant chemotherapy or directly go for surgery only?
And beyond 15 centimeters, the recurrences, survival, and prognosis are almost the same. You can give a neoadjuvant chemotherapy because neoadjuvant chemotherapy is a threefold this thing. It is useful in three occasions. One is for high-grade tumors, one is for leiomyosarcomas, which this thing. They are very useful. I think it can be given neoadjuvant.
So is there any clear-cut cutoff that we can say that after more than this size, we can go for neoadjuvant chemotherapy, or it's just an empirical treatment which we decide on paper?
It is decided by the cancer board, the type of chemotherapy that is useful and the grade of the thing. The grade is not assessed, you are not, cannot give size, mean the size of the tumor doesn't really matter.
It's okay, sir, but grade, how can we assess the grade? Because the same tumor can have different grades at different sites. The size of the biopsy we take at a particular site might be low grade, but once the specimen is resected completely, there might be high grade tissues there in the tumor itself.
You are right. Now, you have various types of assessment by using French staging and grading. Now, you have a grade. Necrosis is one aspect. The hyperchromatic nuclei is one aspect, and you have necrosis in plenty. That means it is not a good prognosis. It goes to
high grade.
Grade 3.
Okay. So, okay, sir. Okay, fine.
Yeah, you can go ahead.
Any other questions from the audience? Yes, Srinivas.
Sir, how to differentiate a lesion whether it is arising from a soft tissue or a bone, sir?
And you'll be more clear.
Clinically, how to clinically differentiate whether a lesion is arising from a bone or a soft tissue, sir?
No. This is very important. Fixity, clinical importance. The fixity, X-rays, and imaging are so good nowadays. I think the CT people will be able to say it in no time. Clinically, it is only attachment to the bone and encircling the bone, whether the bone, it moves in spite of the bone is involved. So, clinical assessment is one aspect, but I think a good imaging will be able to make it.
Suppose in exam they ask, how do you say whether it is a bony lesion or a soft tissue lesion, sir?
Very simple. You move the bone, move the soft tissue, whichever way it moves, if it is stuck to the bone and it moves very vigorously and it is attached to the bone.
Okay, thank you, sir.
Yes. Bone sarcomas, you are more likely to get night pain. It is bone sarcoma, definitely night pain, night cries are more been described.
Hello, sir.
Yes, question.
Sir, is pre-operative biopsy needed, sir?
Up to 3 centimeters, there is no need for a pre-operative biopsy. You excise it with a clearance of another one centimeters. That is all that is required. There is no need for biopsy. But anything more than 5 centimeters, operating, enucleating is a prime.
Okay, sir. And 1 centimeter margin is required for any wide local excision, sir?
Anything. You don't know about the grade of the tumor. It can be a synovial sarcoma with Iurigai grade, or it can be well differentiated atypical lipoma.
Okay, sir.
Any further questions? Sir, if there are no questions, thank you so much, sir, for such a wonderful lecture.
Thank you.
And we'll see you again next week. Anything in the chat?
You have got questions. Sir. You can start that?
Yeah.
You think it?
This bone is involved, should we go for amputation?
Yes. Thank you.
Now, the question, the bone is involved, should we go for amputation or neoadjuvant treatment is the question. You have any...
Lymph-sparing surgeries, bone can be, what they call it as some prostheses are available, which can fix, excise a bit of bone and then vascular and nerves are preserved and you have a gap where the bone doesn't matter. you excise the bone along with that. When orthopedic surgeons are now planning and doing that, limb sparing surgeries. I think it can be done.
Yeah. What is the question?
Sir, is there any role of isolated limb perfusion? Have you any experience about it?
Isolated limb perfusion?
Yes, sir.
I have no experience of that. I have not seen that machine either.
Anyone else? So if there are no questions, then I shall close the session, sir.
Yeah, yeah.
There's some question here in the chat box. In soft tissue sarcoma, is there any role of fancy or directly go to the trunks? I don't know.
FNAC is useful for recurrences. Suppose you operate this thing and the patient comes back with the next to the suture line side, you have a nodule. Then you can do an FNAC and it is valid. But the same thing like follicular carcinoma, the thing, you have a bony metastasis, you do a biopsy, you can do a FNAC. But all other situations, you cannot do a biopsy in follicular carcinoma. Same thing for sarcomas. If there is a recurrence, you can do a biopsy, FNAC. Otherwise, excision. So FNAC is useful for metastasis.
Hello, sir.
Yeah.
Sir, if the cortex of the bone is involved by the soft tissue sarcoma, then should we save off the bone from that part only, or should we go for amputation?
See, this Kawasaki or somebody, that barrier effect I showed you, no? That yes, barrier, sir, effect is mainly given by pleura, peritoneum, perimysium, and then vascular adventitia, all that give a good protection. So you can always separate it from the bone, nothing happens. And there is a big controversy and various papers have come where sciatic nerve can be divided when you have a tumor or the liposarcoma or the sciatic nerve, which is aggressive. And you can spare the bone and give it with chemotherapy so that that is better than the dysfunction that you come across with sciatic nerve or femoral artery. Both are questionable. Aggravated tumor with no metastasis, it can be done. Otherwise, it is not done.
Yes, sir. Sir, if like brachial plexus is involved or something like major nerve is involved, should we go with the nerve repair or something like that?
Yeah, nerve repair, nerve combinations are there. You have got the three divisions and all that. Main nerves are the ulnar, radial, and median. So if that can be salvaged, rest of the things doesn't give much of a problem.
Okay.
Yeah, thank you, sir, once again. And then we'll again meet in the next meeting.
Yeah, thank you. You fix it up your phone.
Okay, sure, sir. Thank you so much. Thanks for your time.